Welcome back to another MTGO Modern League with me, Magix, and in this league we are running a banned Snowblade, so stay tuned and let's go!
Push the goddamn button!
You heard what she said.
Yes, banned Snowblade we run, and this is mostly like the blue-white snow decks that you see occasionally on Goldfish placing in MTGO leagues. Yeah, you have your core of Stoneforge Mystics fetching either of these artifacts, of course, and then you want some targets to equip the sword to. If the Stoneforge dies, well, we have Icefang Kotal and Spellqueller here. Spellqueller also doubles as a counterspell. And if you have a Teferi in play and bounce your Spellqueller back to hand, well, your opponent doesn't get a card. Then we run some cheap counterspells, Jace as your card advantage, some Pass, some Spell Snare, and this is a snow version, so in order to enable make Astrolabe playable, we need these snow basics right here. Since we have then a very good mana base, we can play one Steam Vents and Blood Moons in the sideboard. And Blood Moons and Ashiok should help in the Primeval Titan matchups. And Blood Moon also helps in the Eldrazi Tron matchup, because you shut down Cavern of Souls mainly, and then you can counter the spells. For the counter spells, well, we don't have that many spells. I mean, yes, Spellqueller doubles as counter spells, but to catch a Primeval Titan, we only have Mana League and Cryptics, so that's that. We don't run any Celestial Colonnades, because I want to play on curve, and having too much come into play tapped lands will ruin that. I have one Mystic Sanctuary here, in case we want some spells back on top of our deck. And then we run one Uro, just as life gain card. Some other decks run timely reinforcements. I want to try out the Uro since we are in green anyways. Maybe it should be actually a fourth Spellqueller, I'm not sure. I want to see how this deck, how it plays out. Some versions even play the new Elspeth, but in a meta with Renan 6, where we occasionally face Jund, I don't think she is that great, because she only creates 1/1 tokens, and I think I would prefer Ally of Zendikar still over her, even though she has Escape. Because another reason is that in the sideboard you run Rest in Pieces, right, and you definitely want them against Jund to stop their Renan 6 well used, because else they always cycle their their canopy lands. And yeah, grab it back with the Renan 6, rinse and repeat, so you definitely need Rest in Peace to stop that. Rest in Peace also stops Tarmogoyf's and Kolaghan's commands, of course. And this is also the reason why we run a second Petra Skull here. You need more targets for the Stoneforge Mystic in that matchup, and there are matchups where the Sword is not good, like the Mono Red Prowess and Burn deck, and then you bring in the second Badger Skull actually to have targets for your second to fourth Stoneforge Mystic, literally. Stoneforge, of course, yeah, also nice with the Jace Brainstorm and the Field of Ruin and stuff. All little synergies here. The main issue is that we don't have cantrips like Opt, we only have these Astrolabes and the Kotals to draw through our deck. So we can't control what we draw unless we brainstorm, so we hope with Once Upon a Time to maybe find the right creature for the right job, and since these can't be flashback by Snapcaster Mage, we only play two of those, so yeah, that's mainly it about the deck. Again, Renan 6 is a huge issue because we run so many 1 toughness creatures. Hope to control it somewhat with the Spellqueller or catch it with this measly Spell Snare, but yeah, that's not a given, so some more life gain package in the sideboard, of course, and then maybe Whale of Summer in the black-green matchups to surprise them. Yeah, and that's mainly it. That's what the whole meta consists of. Briny decks, Primeval Titan decks, and some aggressive decks. And we are more the grind decks, so Not that grindy, we are more tempo grindy. It's not like a pure control deck. We are still playing for creatures, playing to the board, and that is the reason why we don't run Supreme Verdicts. And this mana base looks odd, but with the Astrolabe and this being maybe a basic island, we can play out most of our spells, and we also have a Once Upon a Time to wrap something. Maybe another colored mana source, maybe an Icefang Kotal, let's see. Cast without paying the mana cost. And we could grab a Stoneforge Mystic here and play it on turn 2. I don't hate that actually. Our mana base should be fine with the Astrolabe. And then our Field of Ruins can get other basics, so let's enable our game plan, I guess. An island for the Cryptic, play out the Astrolabe. And draw a second copy that you don't need, but well, maybe he plays discard, maybe he plays infects, which would be scary. He does not. Yeah, well, we don't need the Field of Ruin right away. So let's put this in here. Could be Grishelbrand, so let's take the sword for now. Might have the sword on turn 4 then. Yeah, no second land drop, so it's probably a combo deck. In this case, I actually may want to Field of Ruin him next turn. Let's see what he's doing. Nothing. Well then, let's put the sword into play. Let's try to equip here. Let's try to attack. Responds to this trigger. We can hold up Cryptic Command actually. Yeah, but might as well do it like this. Put the two mana in here. He has to pitch something now. Yeah, and it's the Grishelbrand deck or the Eldritch Evolution deck with the Allosaurus Rider, right? So we hold up Cryptic here. Doesn't have green mana now. And in this case, we hold on to the Cryptic here. Try to attack his hand resources. And the green cards even matter. Spirit Guide. Mana Morphos. I feel like I want to counter this actually. Okay. Now he has to beat us here. Nope, he doesn't. Okay. I definitely want these. I want this. I want this. Blood Moon is not as important. Don't think the Stoneforges are actually important. Don't really have time for Path to Exile. Spellsnare could be okay. We don't have time for the Uros. This is not a Jace matchup. It's mainly only about preventing him from coming off in the first turns. And you mostly want to do it with flesh creatures, so even Stoneforge is kind of iffy. Don't want to draw too much dead stuff. Actually don't need the Disdainful Strokes. Let's try it again, not to die on the first turn. Well, this is an awful hand. It doesn't have any interaction, so it is an easy mulligan, I think. This has a Mystical Dispute at least, so let's hope not to die here. Okay. We can stick the Ash Yoke, we should win, but that's not a given. Take one damage, no big deal. They usually don't beat you with damage anyways. Wail of Summer is not bad to protect our counter spells. So I will wait until turn 4 for the Stoneforge Mystic, I guess, or the Ash Yoke plus Wail of Summer. Well, every land he plays out is one less combo piece. Won't fetch here. To wait till he's tapped out to play the Ash Yoke safely, it feels like. Once upon a time is okay, I guess. Could be the second combo piece, maybe, but don't want to fight now about this tapping out here. Now let's see if I can fetch here. Yes, I'm allowed to. Okay. Drop the fourth land drop. Let's play out the Stoneforge now. Pressure into play. Hallowed Fountain. Well, I still have a snap with either of these. Something happens, but I have to get something going, it feels like. Well, maybe with the fifth land drop, we can actually play snap and the sword out in one turn. Or snap end of turn and then use the sword, so yeah, I want this interaction now. Let's make the most out of it. I'm careful here. Still has six cards. Unsure how many lands he has. See if this is a mistake, but I don't think so. Okay. This is the fifth land drop, so now we try to play the Snapcaster end of turn. Then in our turn we can try the sword play. Or we can try to stick the Ash Yoke finally. Yeah, no, I should definitely do this play. Has to fight about this. Doesn't, okay. Let's get rid of his grave. There goes a Pact of Negation. Two Simian Spirit Guides is a huge hit, actually. That can pose a problem for him. Don't care about one damage to the Ash Yoke. It's not like he has Bolt. It's fine. Spell Queller is also nice. Yeah, this should actually do it. Yeah, sometimes this deck does nothing. I played it myself a little bit in the past. Yes, sometimes I'm an evil player, but never done really great with it. You get your 3-2s, sure, but you lose some games to yourself, so a 5-0 is really hard to get. But at least the games are fast. Usually you know if you win or lose in the first few turns. Well, this hand again is kind of iffy. We have two draws until we hit a third land, maybe, yeah. Have to hit a fetch land or something. Seems like a control mirror. No land drop. One more chance, else it's really bad. Land drop. Nope. Dead. 24 lands, no third land drop. Horrible, horrible, horrible. Land drop. Nope. Well, might as well run it out. Yup, remand is extra punishing. Might be a combo deck actually, due to the remand. Yup, and I shouldn't concede, I should at least take the information with me what he has. Snap remand. Yeah, well, take sure. No third land in 11 cards feels bad. It has not something to do with cantrips. Because Jund does draw this naturally, so why can't we? Yep. Well, at least we don't have to discard, I guess. Astrolabe. Finally a cantrip. Here he goes, even countering this one, no? Yeah, sure. Oh. 14 cards in, no third land drop. Why would you? Doing nothing. Sure. So, seems more like a blue-red control deck. Yeah, and he will bounce our second land drop for all of eternity, so let's hope to draw more lands in the second game. Should have a hard time to deal with the Butcher Skull unless he has an Errate. Not a fan of the sword here. Not a fan of Parthas. These are all fine. Guess we don't need the Once Upon a Time. Well, at least can find land drops, right? Oh, stupid game. Well, what else? The Kotals are fine, the Snapcasters are fine, the Astrolabes are fine in case he pays Blood Moon. Spell Quellers are okay, but not stellar. Then he has to use his bolts. They are flash creatures, so if nothing else. Well, I guess we don't need the Mystical Disputes then, and Once Upon a Time. Let's hope to play a normal game here where we draw lands. It isn't too much to ask from our deck. Nearly 20 cards. This hand is pretty much Blood Moon proof. In this case, let's grab a basic island here. Working towards this Mystic Sanctuary. Mystical Dispute is not a bad pickup. Teferi is also a good pick. Yep, let's ship it. Let's see if he has a play here. Might spell snare this, then we play the Teferi out. And he needs an Fry, actually. Yep. Could of course also force the Teferi. Yep. So we are even now. Not sure. Don't care about Blood Moon. Aria of Flames. Well, this is annoying. I need another Teferi now. Or Cryptic. That is neither of those. Field of Ruin is not that bad. Chip the turn, he will opt. Not. Let's get rid of this one. Here comes the opt, we take aura damage. Found the Cryptic at least. So if the Aria gets out of hand, can it use at last? Bounce it, and we found a better skull. Let's bounce this and draw. Let's see if he wants to fight. The mystical dispute is not forever, so I have to get use of it at some point now. Because it's only a mana leak in the end. If he wants to tap out here and doesn't have a second force, we can maybe stick the Better Skull. Try to outrace him. Well, that worked, sure. And we have a force to catch it. Ship the turn back. 6 against 6 now. It comes. Let's hard cast this. That worked. Ice Fang is not bad. We can play it end of turn. Ship it back. Second Aria. Well, not much we can do against this now. Watch is not bad. This forces him to have something. A good spell snare target. Yes. Let's grab the second better skull. Let's attack here. We're still at 35, so it will take some time until the Aria kills us. We have two better skulls, and we can protect them with a bounce, actually. Let's ship the turn here. Might use a lightning bolt. He bounces the land. Well, let's try to use our mana leaks. Well, we can. Ship the turn back. Will not fetch here, protect it from an aberrate. This is great. Can catch the next spell. Automatic sinkhole. Yeah, we can't prevent that, right? So Drum dies, I guess. It's not yet the end of the world. Ship the turn back. He may draw another land at one point. Not so far. Well, okay. Second one into play. And I want a cryptic command on top. stack. Do you have a mystical dispute? The answer is no. Yeah, let's grab the cryptic here actually. Yes. Stoneforge dies, but that's no big deal. Yeah, this is also a reason to place back Quella post-board. You overload his spot removal, actually. Now we have a cryptic. I don't want to run into mana leak, so should the turn back here. The area gets scary. You have a cryptic. Archmage's Charm wants to control our germ. Well, we can at least try to counter draw this. Comes a dispel. And he's going deep with his deck. I can't give him the germ. Wow. Boy, oh boy, and he's not drawing any lands whatsoever. So we have to bounce it back. Yikes. Yeah, I mean, if you don't draw any other lands, then we are dead, sure. Unfortunate. Again, a second land drop, but this time we have two redraws, three redraws even. Let's hope to find the land drop. Nope, why would you? Read not rewarded, and amulet, no land drop. So land drop, at least we have found the second one. Staring stole a card in 2020. Valeria West. Okay. Then second amulet, this can get out of hand quickly. Well, no third land drop makes this easy, I guess. Use the sword. Yeah, third land drop would have prevented this, but you don't get it, and then you are dead. Instead, we draw our damn Badger Skull and Sword. Yeah, well, one land too short. On to the next game with our hate here. The fan of path. The fan of Uro here. Not a fan of Spell Snare. Spell Queller can be okay. At least a clock. We don't need this. Maybe cut one Stone Forge. Can't be right. It's cut one Spell Queller actually. Or one Teferi could also be the case. Yeah. This can get the steam vents actually for the Blood Moon. So yeah, I guess we fetch out the Blood Moon first. Don't care. Just ship the turn here, get my F6 value in. Get my sword. Turn. It's a forest in hand. Nothing else really. Yep, it was a misclick and a pretty badly one. Should have only 5 cards in hand. Yeah, well, it's, guess it's free. So now we should only have 4 cards. Yep. Try to catch this one and hope he doesn't have a Titan in hand already. To have only 3 cards. I bet the misclick will bite me in the ass this game. Might be the case. Let's see. Comes the hardcast Titan. Okay, Tolaria West. Transmute, sure. Another summoner's pact for the next turn. So I guess he doesn't have a Titan. Oh, and we found the Blood Moon. Let's get an island here. Yes. Don't think he can protect this. Yep, okay. Have to be more careful about my clicks here. I think we do it like this on the draw. Yeah, it's mainly about the hate cards actually. Well, we have Stoneforge and Blood Moon. And Ashiok, so gamble for a fetchland, I guess. Sage, well, there goes our Blood Moon, I guess. That's not the fetchland we need. Yep, Slayer Stronghold. And might also nap our sword actually. So it's a stronghold. Hope that this works out. Well, we have milled two summoner's pacts at least. Three, okay. Unfortunately, it won't work out. That's too bad. So we know two of his hand cards. Yeah, I needed this on another turn, and now still missing these damn fucking land drops. It's unbelievable how much you miss land drops. It was 24 cards. It's insane. It's insane. And he doesn't even have a basic forest. Well, at least he has to crack the explosives, I guess. Ancient Stirrings. Well, at this point, I feel like I have to get rid of this stuff. Try to get him down on cards with as much stuff as I can. Try to play the sword here. Goes the Ashiok and the sword. Yeah, well, this was bad. But now, hopefully. Hopefully, he doesn't have a counter here. Or a green mana source. Do you have a Pact of Negation? Basic Forest. Nope. Sure. And then we ship the turn. No need to attack here. Well, let's take this one for good measure. Yep, and then he concedes. Games. We interacted until Blood Moon hit the battlefield, so this sideboard tech worked out. That's great. And though we never drew the astrolabe, now we have the astrolabe but no snow manor. Yeah, guess we keep this and pitch the snapcaster for now. There's no real value yet for him. Okay, I still think that with 24 lands you should draw at least your three land drops every time. Could be dredge, could be mill now. Yikes. Not a lot we can do against dredge here. Second crab, that's scary. And he targets us, so it's mill. Can't probably beat this. Yep. Don't have the clock to beat mill. For whatever reason, people are playing mill. Yep, here comes the archive trap. At least we have an Uro in the grave. I guess that's something. Do you have another trap? To push, or... might as well concede here soon. Cards in hand. Comes the crab again. Land drop. Yup. 10 cards. Snaring bridge, sure. Why not? Why not? Not sure what he's targeting. Cryptic command, okay. So it was, there was even one copy in our deck. Now we kind of have to mill him. You can have your fatal push, ship the turn, first card. Draw cards, surgical. Well, it stops the snapcaster mage I have in hand, but I think it's fine. Plus this. Well, not really, he can't use it with the Teferi. Yeah, never mind then. Let's see. Play the snap out here. can we use? I'm not sure. Much use really. Can get rid of one of his crabs at least, so his next land drop is not lethal. Not sure if we have still a basic in our own land, and guess we take the pass. Then we lose two cards, right? Top three even. Yeah, then never mind. Won't use the pass here. Could fetch one land of our own. So we have five. That is not what this game is about, it feels like. Well, if we prevent one more top deck and then bounce his bridge with an Uro in play and the sword equip. Then what? Oh, we still have six draws. We don't need six. 1, 11 is 2, 13 is 3, and then 4. Yeah, this leaves us still. Now we don't use the pass to exile. We will draw it eventually, I think. Let's not use it. There goes another Jace. Check for a 2-drop. Visions from Beyond has to go to the bottom, unfortunately. So we bounce our own Spell Queller here. Hope that he doesn't hit the land. No. Need two more turns, so it feels like we have to do this. Like we have to do it. Yeah, whatever. This mills us for infinite. Yeah, we probably have lost here. Can only hope he draws. He draws like another ensnaring bridge. That's the only out, or fatal push. Inquisition is also fine, I guess. So we have one more chance. One Spell Queller is out. Yeah. No, all of our Spell Quellers are gone. Yeah, this is fine. So hopefully there's another Inquisition on top. And then we mill him. Well, yeah, no, well, that is how we steal the game against Mill, I guess. Have fun with your enchantment. Well, now he is tilted and doesn't play it out. Yes. Show me your deck. Yep. Okay. Guess we take all these cards in. Might cheese him out with Blood Moon, actually. Don't hate boarding a little bit up, but don't need that much boarding. Here, maybe like this. Let's run 66, it's an extra milk card mostly. Not sure how good the Uros are. Well, this doesn't have green mana. This doesn't have mana leak either. If we had a fetch land here, that would be all I wanted. Well, we can use the pass on our own Snapcaster if nothing else, so I guess. Let's take in a mulligan. Nothing. Yeah, we will definitely path our own Snapcaster, probably. Sure. Now he can take the path, of course. It's awkward, but well. Stainful stroke, okay. Well, at least we have some time. Can still draw the green source, maybe. Nope. Just a cryptic command. We are far off the cryptic, that's for sure, because we have drawn two of our basic snow-covered planes. And he has picked the Disdainful Throw, so I feel like he has archive traps, but I want my mana here, so... He also has Field of Ruin down the line, he will use the traps. Oh, he didn't use them. We have the Blood Moon, but we are still missing land drops. Let's keep the Veil of Summer up. It's a nice counter spell. Sure. If he uses the visions now, he can't use them later. What's this? 5 mana. Hardcast Icav Trap. Well, in this case, let's use the Veil of Summer. Here we found Astrolabe, so we can Blood Moon him. So let's beat the cheese with cheese. Sure, you can see how you die now. Let's hope you have a basic in hand. Have fun. Can still have a bridge, of course, but... Just stop most of his stuff, and we've cheesed it out. Blood Moon going strong here. This won us 2 matches in the end. Compared to Pioneer, Modern surely is kind of broken. Well, that's probably the reason you play this format, I guess. Now, onwards to the last game. I've at least got our cash back. With 3 wins. Let's see if we can go big. Let's grab the 4-1. But then it's not better than our Kiki deck. Yeah, but the Blood Moon is definitely worth it so far, so... Huh. Maybe running Blue-Red Control is a good choice, because Path so far is definitely awkward. Mm. And if you run a lot of Snow Basics, like our opponent, then you could also run Scrat to deal with bigger Eldrazis or what have you. Yeah, it has at least our colors. Let's hope for a third land again. We are on the draw, so hopefully no blazing fast aggro start. Well, and it is aggro. And here comes the Goblin Guide. We don't have removal. Well, there goes Path to Exile. So we have to fetch Shock here. That's kind of awkward. Better Skull is still far off. Swift Spear. Let's fetch out the white green land now before something happens. Because if we draw it now with the Goblin Guide, we can't fetch a white source here, so that would be awkward. And I guess it doesn't really matter, but taking the Swift Spear should be better down the line. Because it can grow bigger. Then he has to use his spells pre-combat. And we take one more here, yeah. So it's guaranteed. Not guaranteed that we take two here. Yeah, no, it is. So next turn we hope to stick the Kotal. Then maybe Stoneforge into Better Skull is good. Not sure. Let's ship it here. Path is not great against burn, but blue red can't do much against burn either. Well, I want to ship the turn back to you. What are you waiting for, my friend? Let's hope he doesn't have Searing Blazes or more bolts. Lava Spike. Go to 7. He has a redraw here. Doesn't have Death Touch, but we have to do what we have to do. Gain 2 life. Then he can Boros Charm us. We go to 3 and are dead. Skullcrack. Well, only 4. Maybe still have a chance. Yes. Petro Skull. Hope for the best. Hope for the rest. Has 2 redraws. Think we are dead because we needed to chuck the Temple Garden in. Goes the Lava Spike. Lightning Bolt. Nope. Well, he has redraws anyways, so... Battle Skull is far off. Yeah. At least virtual chance if he draws more creatures. Maybe. Tap draw. Yep. And he drew the bolt. So, not a lot to do here, only the life gain cards. The sword is not great. Spell snare is okay. This is okay. Don't. Yeah, this can find the Uro at least. Kotals are fine to block with. Not a fan of the chases either, but. All of this is too slow. All of this is really slow. Maybe we can't afford to fiddle around with the astrolabes here. Chases can be okay, so that you draw actually the life gain. I think that the Teferis are weaker. The only thing they really stop is the suspend burn spell, but that's about it. And yes, they can't overload you end of turn, but don't want to play the long game. I want to stick a better skull and close it there, or one of these core firewalkers, that's for sure. So this might be the correct answer then. Well, sure, can at least play out our basics. This is an basic planes, maybe. If you want to play out the Uro, you have to think about this here. Start with the snow-covered island and see what happens, I guess. Taken Mulligan. Timely is also not bad, so we have a good life gain hand here. Yeah, I think fetching a basic planes is fine, especially against the Goblin Guide. The Kotal has Death Touch this time. Yeah, now it's okay, I guess. We can also fetch a basic forest. Two here. That will become really, really scary on the draw, that's for sure. Might have Searing Blaze now. Path to Exile on top, sure. Let's draw it. If he kills the Kotal, we can at least play the Timely and catch back up. Yep, here comes the Searing Blaze. No, a Bolt. Okay. Okay, then we play out the Timely, because he doesn't have Skycrack anymore. Go to 15 here. Go to 11. Should have maybe fetched basic island, but can do that anyways. Later on, we have two fetch lands still. We'll block with everything in case there are some tricks. created there. Cards in hand. Nothing. So we can save some life. Well, in case he has a Skycrake, let's play out the Stoneforge actually. Grab the better skull, and I don't think he's fast enough in this game to stop us. Yeah, sure. Give me more lands. Not sure why he really rings in Path to Exile. Doesn't feel to me like this is worth it. You want to tempo me out. Prevent my life gain with Skullcrack effects, because Better Skull is really slow. Force is not bad. Let's play out the Better Skull anyways. If he kills it, he kills it. I risk the attack here. If he can't stop the Better Skull, that won't matter anymore. We have the pass still for a creature. Lightning Helix. This one is fine. Well, to be honest, I don't even feel like forcing here. Still equip the token, so. Actually, let's do this. Stop his redraws, and he concedes. Okay. Well, now we are on the draw again, and it becomes really difficult. Ooh, we need a lot on the draw. Maybe several core firewalkers can do the trick. But it's scary to block with them if he has a Skycrack. I think you have to block. Won't give me firewalkers. And the white sources, of course. Well, this is a horrible hand. Yes, it has snap path, but not much else. This is too slow, I feel like. Can do better, I think. Well, probably don't have that much time for the spell snare here. But I don't like the force either. Let's do it like this. No one drop. Not sure you can keep a hand without a one drop. Don't have to play the Astrolabe yet. Let's try to catch an Eidolon. Nothing. Okay. Oh, we have a lot of Astrolabes, but I want to keep my mana open. Can't allow an Eidolon to happen. Why cryptic? Don't need cryptic, I need lands. You know, this is better. Let's start with this one. Where's my life gain at? It's no life gain. Could try to stick a Stoneforge here. Doesn't seem like he has a lot. Creatures. Let's get out these battle skulls. Not sure if we are dead here against four cards, maybe with Boros Charm or something. Searing Blaze. Yes. Unfortunate, but too much against that. Can't attack here in case he has a haste creature. Now he can play the Eidolon, but he doesn't have one. Well, then. You have at least still Mana Leak and Spell Snare. Let's play out the other Astrolabe, try to find a core Firewalker maybe. Nope, that's not the Firewalker we wanted. So we ship the turn, cash in the Mana Leak, even the Boros Charm feels better. Have to fetch now. So not the time for the better skull. He still has too much cards in hand. How many Boros Charms do you have? Okay. Where's my core Firewalker? Come on, I need you. Just drawing lands here feels bad. I guess we stick the Battle Skull now. Yeah. There's not much else we are doing here. Well, we can hold up the Cryptic, I guess. He also does play nothing. This is fine, we can trade. Not sure what he really has. Let's play out the other Stoneforge. Okay, so he had a path to exile. That's fine. Maybe he has only Path to Exiles, I'm not sure. Let's grab another Battle Skull. Still hold on to this Cryptic for now. Two cards in hand. Still not sure what he's doing. Can we find finally a Core Firewalker? That would be great. Please, once. Yes! We have did it. Core Firewalker, please. Let's hope he doesn't have a pass to exile for that one. You can read it. Protection from red, and I gain one life when you play a spell. That's red. Probably a lot in this deck. Let that one happen. Okay. And then we hold up the cryptic against the path, and next turn we play the better skull, maybe. Yes, sure. So, three cards in hand. Can you kill us with this? One, two, three, four, five. And then we still have Cryptic up, kind of. Always yes. And let's finally use this. Force him into top deck mode. Chase is not bad here. Now I want my better skull, and I don't think there is mud that punishes us. Yes. Okay. We put the cryptic back on top. Yes. Play the Jace. We Fate Seal you. Sunbag Canyon, yeah, well, it's a redraw, so we chip the turn. Don't think he can kill us with one card, and then we play and equip the Better Skull. Just play the Better Skull and hold up the Cryptic. Sure, that creature doesn't do anything. Yeah, so we have won against Burn, but he kept a weak opener. So I'm not sure he did himself a favor with the slow hand. Nah, we don't have to attack. It's fine, it's fine. Keep up the cryptic. Keep everything under control. We are at 7. No need to rush it here. The writing's on the wall. Even if he has this is uncounterable, 3 mana, burn you for 4. It doesn't really matter. Screw the critics, sure. He concedes. So, we've made the 4-1. Great. We have beaten Burn. But, yeah. I don't really think you need the Oro. Maybe this would be better as timely reinforcements, actually, if you wanted this slot as a hedge against Burn. The Kotals were okay. I still think the Burn matchup is really rough. But the Blood Moons were really nice, so that's something that the Astrolabe allows you to do. Yeah, and with Stoneforge Better Skull, you have at least a late game against Burn, but I wonder if you actually want to run a Teemo version that plays Bolt instead of Path. Then you don't have the Spell Queller, yes, you don't have the Stoneforge Mystics, but the question is if you really need them, because then you have Blood Moon in your main deck against the ramp decks, and you still get most of the value stuff in blue, red, green. So that's something to think about. Anyways, yeah, there you have it. That was Bent Snow Blades, and hope you enjoyed the leak. And till next time, bye bye.